Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over the Excel offset function. So just to give you an idea of what we'll be covering, first of all, we're going to go over the simple offset function. So you can return a value of a cell with a relative location to another cell in your Excel spreadsheet. And then the second thing we're going to do is we are going to show you how to use offset when determining the sum of a relative statement such as the last 4 years. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So let's look at our first example here. What if I wanted to start at B2 and I wanted to return this value right here? I could use the offset function for that. But what I want you to notice first is where this value is with respect to this value up here. So I can see that I am going to go down 2 rows and then over 3 columns. So if I click in G1 and I type equals offset with a left parenthesis, the first argument I'll be asked for is my cell reference, or where is my starting point? So in this case, let's just click on B2. And then I'm going to type a comma. And my next argument is, how many rows away from this cell do I want to go? So in our case, remember I showed you we want to go down 2. So I'm going to put a 2 and then type a comma. And then how many columns over do I wish to go? Well, in this case, I want to go over 3. So I'm going to end my parentheses and type enter. And I can see that I am being returned with this 355 right here.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
I would like to show you something else with offset too, because offset is also directional, but I'm not sure that that last example picked up on that. So I'm just going to type here and I'm going to do what we just did, but in the reverse. So I want to start with what is in E4, but this time I want to move up and to the left. Remember last time we moved down and to the right. So I'm going to type equals offset with a left parenthesis. And this time I'm going to pick E4 as my cell reference. And then I'm going to type a comma. But I want to go up this time. By default, Excel will assume that my number is going down unless I put a negative sign in front of it. So this time I'm going to put a negative 2, and then I'm going to type a comma. And then for my column argument, Excel assumes by default that you're going to the right. But if I put a negative 3 in this case, I'm going to go 3 columns to the left. So if I close my parentheses and hit enter, I'm now being returned with this 492. So just remember, if I look up here, a positive sign means you're going down and then to the right. And if I click in here, a negative sign means you're going up and to the left. So just keep those signs in mind when you're determining which direction you want to move with the offset function. Our next example is, how could I sum up a relative statement such as the last 4 years that I have entered here, or the last 5 years? The term last is going to be relative. So if I type in here, I'm going to just type offset for now. So equals offset with a left parenthesis. And my reference here, I'm just going to click B1 because that's the beginning of the column that I'm going to use. And then I'm going to type a comma. But now for my rows argument, I want to actually count how many entries I have in column B. So I'm going to type the word count with a left parenthesis and then just highlight column B and end my parentheses. And then I'm going to type a comma. And then how many columns do I want to go over? I actually want to go over 0 because I already have all of my data in column B. So I'm going to type 0. And then I'm going to type a comma. And now this height argument is what is going to return my last 4 cells. So I'm going to type a negative 4 in here. Close my parentheses and hit enter. And now I can see that I am getting my last 4 years here. See, the formula is spilling down into the rows underneath. So in order to avoid this spilling, I'm going to click back up here, and in between the equal sign and offset, I'm just going to type sum with a left parenthesis and then go all the way to the end of my offset formula and type a right parenthesis and hit enter. And now I can see the sum totaling up right here instead of spilling over into my four rows. However, because this is relative, if I go down here and I type 2024, and let's just type a one in here, and if I hit enter, I can see that my sum up here has gone way down because now I'm summing the last four cells. So if I select all four of these and I look down here, I can see that my sum is 5688, just like it is up here. So hopefully that gives you some tips on how you can use the offset formula to do various things in Microsoft Excel. If you would like a more in-depth discussion of this, I will include a link to our blog entry on this topic in the description below on YouTube. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.